All right, so we're going to dive into the case study right here. So let's check it out.
All right, so I think the first thing we want to do is pick a reference limb. Will, which limb do you want to pick?
I'm seeing more things on that left side, so that seems to be more of the area of concern for me. So that's going to be my reference limb there.
All right, let's mark it.
Perfect. Okay, so now we're going to start from the bottom and go up. So now we're looking at the ankle, particularly I like to start with like initial contact.
Okay, looking at that left leg, and it's going to go into slow-mo, and that's going to give us a really nice chance.
So we've got a heel hit there on the left side.
Yeah, but it's quick.
Very quick. Boom.
Boom. All right, let's go ahead. Let's mark abbreviated heel contact.
Yeah, toes aren't up there for very long.
But then that one, it almost looked like it was a flat foot. Did you see that?
Yeah, it definitely varies a lot.
Like there, she doesn't have heel contact. Gosh.
You can almost kind of go between these two because it's like...
Let's put them both down and we'll just maybe kind of, you know, say maybe inconsistent.
It works. I'd also say that there's definitely not enough dorsiflexion as well. So I'm going to call that an adequate dorsiflexion there.
I think that's fair. I think that is fair.
That kind of makes sense with the abbreviated heel contact.
Yep. Okay, so let's move into single leg support, still at the ankle here. Still on that left side, since we've got this lateral view. Boy.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, the heel stand glued to the ground. So I'm going to say no heel off on that one.
Because even through terminal stance, she really doesn't pick it up until she's ready to swing the leg.
Yeah. All right, let's go back in here. Let's start at that slow motion again. So even here, we are repeating it.
Yeah, definitely. That's where I want heel rise, not getting it.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. So then let's go into the swing leg advancement.
Yep.
Okay.
So left foot comes through here. And the foot's almost plantar flex there.
Yeah,
so
definitely inadequate.
Definitely inadequate just dorsiflexion.
Dorsiflexion. Would you call that a toe drag?
I haven't seen it make contact with the ground, so I'm going to say no for right now.
Yeah, you'd almost want to look at her shoe to make sure that that's not happening because you'd see some scuffing, but no, I don't see it. She's clearing it.
Mm-hmm. So that might be something we might check in the anterior posterior view as well.
Okay, really quick, since she has that inadequate dorsiflexion, let's look at her right and see if she's doing a vault there to clear it, or what is she doing in order to clear it? Maybe we'll wait till we see the AP view. Let's see.
Yeah, let's go and jump to the AP view really quick. It's a nice thing about having video, we can go through all this stuff here.
So still looking at the left ankle.
Yeah, so it doesn't look like it's clearing the ground, and I'm not seeing any vault on that side.
Yep, me neither.
So.
She's almost doing like a hip hike in order to clear it on the left side rather than a vault, so I'm not going to mark that.
Yeah. So now that we're in this view, this really sets us up well for looking at the calcaneus as well, in this anterior posterior view. That's going to allow us to be able to see the inversion and eversion. So let's see here, especially as you make
contact.
Looking
at that left, boom, yep.
Yeah. I don't really see it, like she makes contact like pretty neutral, but then as soon as she like loads into it, I'm seeing her go into that eversion where that heel is going out.
Yeah, because there is a natural, like there is a natural kind of eversion that occurs, but this is abrupt.
Yeah, pretty dramatic there.
And dramatic.
And she carries it through the whole single limb support. So it's basically excess eversion, I would say, for loading response and then into that whole single limb support eversion.
Yeah, I would as well. Let's watch it one more time. Yeah.
Yeah. And then moving over to the swing. Let's see here. This would be a good view for it. I guess I can see excess inversion on that one. It's sort of half and half.
It's just so inconsistent. It more looks like a wobble. Like it's poor motor control. I don't really think it's like you can just see that wobble coming through swing. I don't know. I'm not going to mark it, but you can. I just feel like it's too wobbly through there.
Yeah. All right, let's look at toes. And for this one, I'm going to choose the lateral view to talk about this one here. Okay, so let's see here. Big things, we're looking for the clawed. Obviously, she's wearing shoes right now, so we're not going to be able to see that one.
Right.
But here, we should be able to see if she's getting the metatarsophalangeal extension.
Because she'd get that little crease in her shoe.
Yeah, that's a great place to look for it, is looking for like a crease, basically, where the toes would be. And I'm not seeing it.
I don't really see it. Boy, that's tough. Well, let's mark it down, and maybe we can just say, like, just, you know, knee barefoot, let's say.
Yeah, that would give us a better sense of what's going on.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to bring it back to the start of our slow motion here. So now we're going to jump into the knee now. So here's the left as it comes in. Things looking fine as far as like the initial to me.
Yeah, you want a little bit of flexion in that knee upon loading response, and she's got that. That looks great. All right, but then she comes into stance.
Yeah, her stance is kind of carrying almost a little bit of flexion into it, honestly. Like she's not fully extending. Oh, and then.
I think it's not that you're seeing the flexion upon loading response. I think we're seeing boom. And well, let's see it on the way back. But I think she's going into that extensor thrust, and that's what you're seeing more than anything.
That was not too bad.
No.
We'll see about this one.
Oh, she's not. Okay, well, maybe. There's a little bit there. There's a little bit there. It almost happens late.
Yeah. Kind of. Let's look at this in real time.
Oh, there, yeah. Okay.
Big one there. Yeah, so we saw that knee popping back into that extent, like that hyperextension. Yeah, you can kind of see it here as well. Boom, pop, pop.
Okay.
So, yeah, definitely an extensor thrust there. So there was that difference. So you had actually that knee kind of forcefully moving back, especially as you got more towards that terminal stance.
Yep. Yeah, you could just see it. Doesn't look good.
Yeah, this is one of the things that's important, I think, to see actually in true normal motion there. All right.
Can we take a look at the AP view? I just want to make sure we're not missing any valgus, varus, anything like that.
Mm-hmm. Let's see here.
So.
This is hard to see. This is like one of those cases that would probably be good. It would have been really helpful if we had pulled up the pant leg above the knee there. So we're kind of missing a little bit.
Yeah, because it almost looks like she's got a little bit of a valgus positioning there. But then she also has so much calcaneal eversion that... Is it coming from the foot position? Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hard to tell. I don't see anything in there that I could really reliably say, like, yes, that's what I saw. So for me, I wouldn't put anything there as of right now. So maybe something you would look at again.
Okay. All right, let's look at that thigh as best we can. So starting kind of in the sagittal plane, looking flexion and extension here. Again, we're looking at that left side. Here it comes through. That looks good.
Yeah.
Here it comes back. That looks pretty good. I see 20 degrees of extension. Yeah, I think that looks good.
Mm-hmm. So now as we get into like adduction, abduction, internal rotation, external rotation, this is going to be best to be seen in that AP view. So we're going to get here, especially in the slow motions, to be easier to see. All right, taking a peek here.
All right, I am seeing medial rotation.
Definitely.
And maybe that's why I thought it was valgus, and it's actually, like we talked about earlier, more medial rotation from the hip.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah, you can just see where the seam of her pants almost, mm-hmm. you can see that lateral seam of her pants because she's medially rotated. All right, are you seeing that in swing as well or just in stance?
I'm seeing it primarily in stance right now, but let's take a look. Yeah, I would actually argue I see a little bit of that in swing as well.
Yeah, I do too.
I think also one thing I'm seeing here is occasionally is adduction. It's one of those things that's not coming through every single time, but like right there, like her left foot crossed right in front of her right.
No, that's true.
It was almost kind of like what you might call a scissoring.
Yeah, basically. But that one didn't look like it.
Exactly. Let's see what happens here again. No, that one's good.
That one looked all right.
And how do we come in next one? That one's fine too. So yeah, this is kind of one of those ones that's.
Yeah, but...
So we come here.
That looks...
close. Not bad. That was there, very adducted there. Adducted there. Adducted there. I would mark that one.
I
think it's happening with enough frequency to warrant doing that. Because if it's happening here, it's definitely going to be happening out in the quote-unquote real world.
Yeah, no. All right. Okay. All right. Fine. Well... This is one of those ones that it's so inconsistent, and I wonder if it's true adduction or just, again, such poor motor control. But either way, I think we go ahead and mark it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right, and now we're going to go up to the...
Inconsistent.
Pelvis, yes, very. All right, now moving into the pelvis. So for this one, I'm going to capture a little bit from the side here. Mm-hmm. So especially looking for that forward rotation or backward rotation. Let me fast forward it so we can actually see that left side here. Here we go.
Kind of stays back there. You can almost see her thigh come forward in flexion. Right there, thighs forward, but I can't really see if...
Not a dramatic movement of the pelvis overall.
No, I'm really...
kind of stiff overall.
Can you see it from an AP view?
Let's take a look. Here is it. It should come through here. Yeah, that doesn't really look like a forward. Much of it.
There's just not... It's more from the hip, isn't it? Like that. Yeah, you can really see it there. It's way back there. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, so let's put maybe inadequate forward rotation.
Yeah, so that would be occurring in the swing limb advancement there.
Yeah. How about, now remember I said that she wasn't vaulting on the other side, but she's hiking to clear it. So I'm going to put a hip hike for sure, because look at that. That's she doesn't have that dorsiflexion. How is she clearing it? Boom, there's a little hip hike.
Yeah, that does seem to be where it's coming from. Yeah, because with the inadequate dorsiflexion, it makes you think that something's got to be happening there. Mm-hmm. So it looks like that's where it's coming from.
I think it's more of a hip hike. Maybe maybe even a little circumduction, and that's what we're seeing with that adduction.
All right, I'm going to take a look from the side. I want to kind of see from an anterior tilt versus posterior tilt. And yeah, pretty clearly, I'm seeing pretty much an anterior tilt there.
Very much so.
Yeah, those hips are, or the pelvis is very much rocked forward.
Very much so.
So kind of like what we're talking about, that's probably like weak glutes that we're seeing.
Mm-hmm. Weak glutes, weak abs, yeah.
Yeah. At least something for us to investigate further.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right, is that pretty much it for the pelvis, I think?
I think that's it, yeah.
Okay. All right. So then we move on to the trunk. So let's start off with the forward and the backward limbs. That's what we can see in this particular thing here. Not bad.
Not bad. I think that anterior pelvic tilt kind of keeps her more upright, to be honest. You know, you'd expect to almost see her flopped forward, but... Yeah.
From a more general standpoint, I mean, she's got, like, forward head, but, like, overall, looking in, like, thoracic spine especially, it's not that far forward.
Not enough for me to mark it.
Yeah, I'm actually pretty happy with this. So let's look at it from this AP view, and so now we're looking at left versus right. We're going to come here in this slow motion here in just a second. Let's see here.
Okay, so she's working at the left leg in stance. So when she's in stance, what's her trunk doing? A little bit of a, what was that, left lean? So in stance. I see a left trunk lean. I see that left shoulder
very
drop.
Very slightly, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I kind of look at her shoulders. There's the drop.
There's definitely a difference within the trunk. Like if we're looking at shoulders, and if we ideally like to see them to be level, mm-hmm. you can definitely see them tilt towards the left as she goes over there. So it's not like the most dramatic one that we can see, but I would definitely, say that it's certainly there.
Yeah. Okay. How about in swing? She's got a little bit of just a slight, and I think it's because she's hiking her hip.
Yeah.
To get that hip hike, she kind of leans to the right in swing.
Yeah. I agree with that. So it's kind of a combination between those two things.
A hip hike slash a right lateral lean just to kind of clear that foot.
Again, not the hugest one, but definitely there.
Yeah. Want to mark it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Good. Any global... kind of big picture things that we want to write down here.
Let's look at it in real time speed really quick.
So definitely a decreased gait speed.
For sure.
And,
and looking down, like we were saying, that forward head. And her arms aren't really swinging that much. They're kind of just held down by her side quite a bit. So, it's a little bit abnormal there.
Good speed.
So.
Forward head. Decreased arm swing. Yeah.
Yeah, that's the same.
Probably not the most efficient. Good.
All right, and so we're gonna stop there. And so that is our analysis of our reference limb. And so we spent quite a good amount of time there, but we wanted to be thorough. We wanted to spend time and kind of talk about why we're seeing different things. And already you can see that we actually differ on kind of our interpretation of things that should be pretty clear cut. This is why you can kind of see that reliability is not the highest for this particular assessment. But everything that we're saying is definitely worthy of talking about. Mm. So, like, you know, where we might differentiate on something, where we might check it versus not, that doesn't mean that it's not a concern, that there's not, you know, certainly issues that are going on there. It's just that I think oftentimes our definitions of what we might be seeing, I don't think are well represented in standardized forms like this.
You also saw how heavily we relied on the video.
Yes.
We would have been in trouble if we hadn't had that video in order to kind of go back to say, oh, I want to see that in AP. I want to see that in the lateral view. And so you could really see just how great it was to have that video versus asking this particular person to walk however many times we needed in order to perform that full analysis. Mm-hmm. So great way to practice. It slows it down. You can see that slow-mo. And then also, if you can, with the patient, videotape them to give you that allowance to go back and forth and really make sure you're seeing everything that you want to put down that form. All right, so we just did the analysis of the left limb. So let's go ahead and let's quickly change out our forms and let's do one on the right.
Yep. So now we've got a clean form ready to go. And again, now you know our reference limb was that left side, but we're now looking at the right side kind of in the context of the other opposite side. So this one should go a lot faster because we've already hopefully gotten most of the big issues out of the way. We've already done our global assessment as well. So those things we don't have to necessarily look at. All right, so again here, we're taking a look at the right leg. And let's go ahead and dive in.
Yeah, good.
So there we go. We've done our assessment now. Now we have all of this tool, which has a list of deviations that we're able to use. And these are all things that you can document on as well. One way that you can use this is that as you do treat a patient, you can kind of use these different areas of the body that we're seeing dysfunctions in order to guide your treatment or guide your interventions that you select. And over time, you could also potentially use this to go back and check over and see if you're still seeing those impairments that you saw on that first day when you did the analysis.
Like we talked about before, the nice thing about this form is that it does break it into the weight acceptance, single limb support, and swing limb advancement sections. And the nice thing about that is you can really see, boy, she's really struggling. On this left side, you can see how many places we marked in this weight acceptance down here at the ankle calcaneus. You can really see how many things we marked at the swing limb. It just kind of helps guide where we're going to focus our treatment.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Thanks for following along with our gait observational analysis series. We hope that this was informative and that you know what the next thing to do is print off more of these forms and go practice with the case series that we've got.
Yeah, we've got a number of different case studies that you can use as part with these different forms. You can find those on our YouTube channel at youtube.com/missiongait. And we've got a number of different pathologies. And even for some of the cases, we have multiple videos of the individual as they progressed along. Actually, the video you watched today, we actually have an example of this patient with an orthotic and with a cane as well. And so you can kind of observe the differences in her gait pattern once you add those things back into the mix. So highly recommend you check those things out. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, let us know down in the comment section below. And thanks for tuning in.